Hi friends, welcome to Techies Buddy. In this video, we will see how to install the LAMP package in Ubuntu. For installing the LAMP package, we need to connect to the EC2 instance using the PuTTY. After that, we need to update the OS packages for that running this command. Sudo apt update. Now we can install the Apache by using the sudo apt install apache command. It will ask you to confirm additional space will be used. Press Y. Then it will install the required packages. Wait for 100% completion. Now Apache module is installed. In our server, Apache web server is ready. We can check it is installed or not by hitting the EC2 instance IP address. For knowing the IP address of EC2 instance, open the AWS console and copy the public IP4 address and paste into the another tab. Now we can see another way to know the EC2 instance IP address from terminal itself using this command curl http iconzip.com. Still the website is not loaded. For fixing this issue, we need to enable the few port numbers in the security group. Now click on the security tab. Here select the security group. Now click on the edit inbound roles. Here we need to enable the port 18443. For that click on add rule. Now from the select box, we need to select the HTTP among these options. Here HTTP means port 80 only. In general, web server will run on port 80. Then choose the source from anywhere. In the same way, we need to add another rule for HTTPS. That is port 443. This is for SSL enabled web servers. After adding, scroll down and click on the save rules button. It will save the recently made changes in the security group. Now refresh the tab. It will load the default Apache configuration page. Now we can start the MySQL installation. For that, using this command sudo apt install MySQL server. It will ask you for confirmation of additional space that will be used. Press Y and then enter to continue. Wait until finish the installation process. It will take few minutes to complete this process. Now we need to run the secure script for MySQL. Sudo MySQL secure installation. This will ask you if you want to configure the validate password plugin. This is an optional. If you want the strong password usage case, you can enable this one. Right now I am choosing no. It will ask you for the root password. Enter your desired password here and press enter. Now again retype the same password and press enter key. It will ask you the remove anonymous users. Press Y and enter to continue. Disallow root login remotely. Press Y and enter to continue. Remove the test databases and access it. Press Y. For reload privileges table now. Press Y and enter to continue. Now MySQL installation process is completed. For entering to MySQL console using this command sudo MySQL. Now exit the MySQL shell with the exit command. For knowing the MySQL version, type MySQL --version and press enter. It will show the installed version of the MySQL. Installing the PHP. To install PHP packages, run sudo apt install libapache-mod-php php-mysql. It will ask you for confirmation of additional disk space that will be used. Enter Y and press enter. It will start installing the PHP packages. Now PHP installation is completed. For knowing the PHP version, type php-v. It will show the currently installed PHP version. For checking the Apache default configuration file, switching to the etc folder, then Apache 2, giving ls for listing all the files and directories in the folder. Now switching to the sites available folder. Here 000 default configuration file is the Apache default configuration file. For editing, use this command nano 000 default configuration file. Here we can see the web server directory path. Press Ctrl plus X for exit from the edit mode. Now switching to the var www.html path. Give ls command to see the files in this path. index.html file is available. Now open this file in edit mode. Nano index.html. Remove all the content in this file by pressing Ctrl plus K. Now return our own code. Now press Ctrl plus X. Will ask you to save the file. Give enter. Now refresh the EC2 instance IP address previously opened on the web. Now we can see the written code is displayed here. Again modifying the same file content and see the reflection also. For changing the directory, run this command. Sudo nano etc apache 2 mods enable directory configuration. Here change the index.php position to first. Now we can create the info.php file var www.html path. For that run nano info.php. Here print the php info function. After saving and closing the file, we shall need to reload the Apache so that changes take effect. For that run sudo systemtell reload apache 2. Now run the info.php on the web. It will show you the php configuration and install plugins information. The next video will see how to install phpMyAdmin in Ubuntu and accessing the MySQL server from it. Thanks for watching it. For more technical videos, please subscribe to our channel. If you like this video, please like and share this video.